Hello, and welcome back to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. In this episode, we're going to see how to add shortcut keys to those main menu bar options in your .NET MAUI desktop application. Welcome back to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. I'm your host, Gerald, and in this episode, we're going to see how to add shortcut keys or keyboard accelerators to your menu bar items. So on desktop apps for Windows and for macOS in .NET MAUI, you can have a main menu bar. We've seen that in a previous video. I highly recommend that you go check it out. It's linked at the end of this video or find it down in the video description below. And with that menu bar implemented, you can very easily per menu item add a shortcut key, which we call keyboard accelerators, and with those shortcut keys, your user can very easily trigger a piece of functionality by just pressing a couple of buttons on a keyboard, which is typically a huge productivity boost over going with a cursor, clicking a thing, getting into a menu, clicking another thing. Very slow, just use the keyboard, very much faster. So let's check out how to implement that in your .NET MAUI desktop application. So here I flipped to Visual Studio 2022 on Windows. You can do the exact same thing with the exact same code on macOS, obviously. That's the power of .NET MAUI. You implement it once and it rolls out to all the applicable platforms. And here you can see a little bit of code. This is basically just your new .NET MAUI project that you can find in Visual Studio. But I already added a little bit of code here with these menu bar items. Again, I highly recommend that you watch the other videos on how to do that. But you have these menu bar items for this content page. So here you can see on the highest level, we have an app option and a YouTube option. And with that in place, we can add menu sub items to that. So we have this one item under here, which is count. And then here we have hello, a separator, and then some sub items for a menu that folds out, and you can see it right here. So if I run that really quickly, you can see how that all works. And what we're going to do here into one of these menus, we're going to add these keyboard accelerators so that you can not only click on these menu items, but you can also reach them by keyboard. So here you can see this is just the new .NET MAUI project template. If you click here, you can see that it increments, clicked four times. And here you can see this app and this YouTube menu. And under that, we have count. And under YouTube, we have hello, the separator, and you want to subscribe to my channel. Maybe you want to subscribe to my channel. The functionality isn't implemented here. So if you could just do it manually for now, click on that subscribe button, that would be amazing. Thank you so much. And here under that app, we have this count. And whenever I click that, this is hooked up to the same event handler as for this purple button right here. So if I click that, you can see that it actually flips to five times. And I could do it again and it goes to six, right? But how cool would it be if I could do that with my keyboard that I have right here? So let's close this for a little bit. And here we have this menu flyout item. You can see the count is text. The clicked is hooked up to that same event handler on counter clicked that we have here on this button down below. And you can see that it's self-closing, right? We have this slash right here, which means it's self-closing. We don't want to do that. We want to have this closing tag right here. And now we can add properties in between. That's how XAML works. And we can say menu flyout item dot keyboard accelerators. See, there we have it. IntelliSales is helping me. And we have this one. Actually, we can make this one. This is a collection, so you can add multiples here. If that's what you want, please try to avoid to add multiple things here and maybe colliding shortcut keys so that you will have weird behavior if you're reusing the same combination in a couple of places. You can definitely add more than one shortcut to the same action, but beware, it can get a little bit messy and unclear to your user, right? So you typically probably don't want to do that. And then inside of here, you can have that keyboard accelerator. And that's what I was going to say earlier. You can make this one self-closing, right? This is just one tag. We're going to add some properties so we can make this self-closing and not add too much XAML. There is enough XAML already. And here we have a couple of properties, and the main ones are the key and the modifier. And for the modifier, you can immediately see IntelliSense is helping me. We have this enumeration, and that's like the keys that you keep pressing down while you are pressing like another key, right? That sounds a little bit abstract, but think of copy and pasting, control V, control C, you hold down the control key and then you do the other key together with that, right? So that's kind of like your modifier key. You can see the alt, the command, which is typically for macOS, right? So we also have the macOS and Windows specific buttons right here. We have the Windows key as well, and the shift and the control and none, which is the default, right? So you can just press A and that will do the shortcut key, which is probably not something that you want, but you can do it if that's what you wish for. So we are going to do control, and then we're going to do C because we're going to do count, right? So you can do C, you can do capital or small, doesn't really matter. And we're going to have that in place. Now, if I run the application again, you're going to see that I can do control C and it will do control count. And what you can also see, we have this functionality here under the app menu, and you can see that it now got this little annotation right here with control C. The user can see that there is a shortcut available for this. Comes out of the box, it will just be there. And you can see here, nothing on my sleeve. So here, my two hands, I'm going to pick up the keyboard so that you can see that this is going on. Control C, I'm doing it right now. Watch the screen, watch me, watch the camera, watch the screen. And you can see that the counter is incrementing, right? By just pressing this key right here. And I can also still go to this app menu and click count from right here, and it will increment all the same. So that's how easy it is to implement keyboard accelerators in .NET MAUI. And that's how easy it is to do that. You might have already have that menu bar in place, the menu items in place, just add those shortcut keys and your users will thank you for that, because it's so much easier to do a couple of actions through the keyboard than to navigate through the cursor over and over again, especially those actions that you need to do over and over inside of your application. So with how easy this is to add, it would be a shame to basically not do it. It would be a crime to not do it. So for iOS and Android, they get more and more features on their tablets usually. You already can hook up pointer devices and keyboards as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if at some point this will implement it for iPadOS as well. Or maybe it already is and I'm just not aware because I'm not a big tablet user. Please let me know down in the comments if that's the case and let me learn from you. Now you might ask yourself, Gerald, but what if I want to listen to keystrokes and maybe add some shortcut keys without the menu bar? Is that even possible? Yes, that is absolutely possible. Anything that is available on the underlying platforms is available through .NET MAUI, although it might not be available in the .NET MAUI layer, but you still have the power to reach out to the underlying platform and implement that yourself. But luckily, our most wonderful program manager, David Ortnow here at Microsoft, has a plugin for you to do exactly that. Plugin.maui.keylisteners, I think it's called. So look that up. I will link it down in the show notes. And that will allow you to listen to any kind of keystrokes on your keyboard and hook up some functionality for that for Windows and macOS. If you want to see that in a video, please let me know down in the comments. Otherwise, don't forget to like, subscribe, and maybe check out this playlist right here with more .NET MAUI 101 episodes where you can learn piece by piece about .NET MAUI in just a few minutes. See you for the next one.